Hey everyone! So with all of the updates happening recently, it's been a little while since I've made a speculation video. However, a couple of weeks ago we got a very interesting update to the roadmap which had some really surprising changes. So we're going to be talking about one of those items today, the Bonnie Merchantman. Before we start though, if you end up enjoying this video, please consider hitting that like or subscribe button. It really helps me out. So I want to start off with a brief background of the Bonnie Merchantman. The Merchantman is the main cargo vessel, and actually just the main ship of the Bonny species, which is an alien race known for being merchants. And this ship has actually been around for a very long time, since 2013 actually, when it was unlocked during the initial funding campaign. Now, throughout the years, we've been given various descriptions about what the Merchantman's capabilities are, how big it's going to be, and how much cargo it can carry. And while those have changed a lot, and I expect them to change even more when it actually comes out, the description of the main role of this ship has pretty much been the same. It's a ship designed to fulfill all the needs the Bonnie would have as they're traveling around the verse buying and selling items. So this means that it's got a few desirable characteristics. First of all, being the primary vessel of a race of traders means that it'll have a sizable cargo capacity. It'll probably be the highest internal cargo capacity besides the Kraken, at least that's what I expect. Also, the Bonnie use the ship as a marketplace, and we've heard a lot about the internal shop kiosks that you'll be able to set up to sell various items. This could be a nice way to make some additional income beyond just hauling commodities as a player using the ship, and although some people aren't too interested in this feature, it shouldn't really detract from the ship if you just want to haul stuff. And then the last main feature that's often been called into question is the ship's combat capability. I'm confident that the other two aspects of the ship will be delivered upon, but throughout the years the ship has been described as fast, durable, and having a lot of firepower to defend itself with. I think it does make sense for the ship to have some of those traits since the Bonnie supposedly just fly a lot of merchantmen and convoys as protection, and they don't really use much of an escort beyond that, but it just seems like a ship with all of the aforementioned features is too good to be true. Thankfully though, we should find out what direction they've gone with it soon enough. So now moving on to what's actually been added to the roadmap, it's actually even more exciting than what I initially thought when I had heard that it actually showed up on there. So no actual work has been done on building it in-game yet, as far as we can see, but they've actually been reconcepting it for a couple of months now. So yeah, looking at the progress tracker here, you can see the upcoming work that is scheduled to start in mid-July with the EU vehicle team, and they'll be the ones actually working on implementing it into the game. But then moving on up to the vehicle concept art team, you can see that they've been at work on this for a while. It looks like they started at the end of last year, if the figure for number of weeks is correct. So yeah, this is really good news. Just like I mentioned, the Merchantman is a really old ship at this point, and a lot has changed with the game since it was first announced all the way back in 2013. Last time we heard about it, we knew it had to be reconcepted, and that's about all the details we were given. There were a few non-committal statements about wanting to make sure it fits inside of a large hangar, but we weren't given many details. But this lack of details makes sense now, because I'm sure no one over there wanted to make any statements about how it was going to turn out, knowing that it was possibly going to be completely reimagined in a few months from then. Thankfully for us though, I'm pretty sure that we'll be seeing some of the results of this reconcepting effort soon, because with CIG bringing back Invictus for another year, I think we'll probably be having another Alien Week just after it. So Alien Week last year could barely be considered an event. There was really no in-game component to it, and it was mainly just a ship sale with a few community competitions and a few lore posts. I imagine that this year it'll be sort of the same thing again, which makes sense because it would be difficult to have another in-game event right after Invictus, but hopefully they'll take the opportunity to share some of the concept work from the Merchantman with us. And they'll definitely want to do that if they really want to drive some sales. So yeah, the Merchantman has actually been being worked on for a while now, and hopefully we'll see some of that work in early June. So in this part of the video, I just want to make a few guesses about what we'll actually be getting with this ship, just for fun, and hopefully we'll get to see what I'm right or wrong about pretty soon. So I want to start off with the ship's cargo capacity, because that's one of the things that we've been given different figures on throughout the years. Since the ship is so old, when it was initially unveiled, SCU wasn't even the system used for measuring cargo. So the figures for how much cargo it could carry have changed a lot, but right now the current listing for this ship is a massive 3,500 SCU, and the overall length of the ship is still listed at 160 meters. So knowing that a standard 1 SCU container measures 1.25 meters on each side, we can get a general sense of whether or not it's possible to fit that much cargo in a ship of this size. And actually, at 160 meters, this capacity is really no problem. So assuming that this area is entirely dedicated to cargo, and assuming that the width of this area is at least 50% greater than its height, again, this is just a very rough estimate, the raw cargo capacity of this area would be in the range of around 10,000 SCU. Now, obviously, this is way more than we're gonna get, and it also doesn't take into account stuff like needing to be able to walk between the rows of cargo on the cargo grid so that you can have access to the stuff without having to unload everything. So to get an estimate of how much space those sort of things take up generally, I did the same sort of calculation for the Carrick and its underslung cargo area, and I came up with about 1,000 SCU worth of space. Since the Carrick's actual capacity is a bit under half of that, I think it's a reasonable estimate to say that if the internal layout of the eventual merchantman is somewhat similar to this early concept art, there's potentially space for a bit over 4,000 SCU of cargo. Again, this isn't precise at all, but really the point of this is just to see if those listed values are feasible. And while I initially came into this thinking that there's no way that 3,500 SCU was possible for a ship of this size, if the merchantman ends up being 160 meters long, it definitely would be. But one interesting possibility is that more recently when the merchantman was brought up, John Crew mentioned wanting the ship to fit into a large size hangar. Now it's hard to know if this is still the plan, but I personally think that he was looking at adding this constraint mainly so that not having access to XL hangars wouldn't limit the flexibility of the ship. At the moment, it is a bit of a pain to use a ship that only fits in XL hangars, since there's only 4 locations right now in Stanton with them. However, with ship-to-station docking moving along quite well, it seems like it should be less annoying to deal with huge ships moving forwards. So I think that they might not be as concerned with it being able to fit in large hangars because of that, but let's just explore what it might actually be like at a smaller size. Now, I couldn't find the dimensions of large hangars anywhere, but thankfully we have the Carrick, which is pretty much as big of a ship as possible that can fit into a large hangar. But yeah, I do think the Carrick is a good example to look at of why it might be a bad idea for them to try to shrink the merchantman based on a hangar size. To get the Carrick to fit into these hangars, they had to make some compromises, which are small in some instances, like how the Carrick isn't quite as slender looking as some of the concept pictures, and also how the upper bridge seemed like it initially was planned for the people up there to be able to look down at the pilots on the lower bridge, but there just wasn't enough space for that extra length. And then there's the sillier and hopefully temporary compromises, like not being able to use the side ball turrets when landed anywhere, since if you extend them while you're in a hangar, you won't be able to fit through the doors as you're leaving. But this means that if you're planet side, you also can't use those turrets. So yeah, while I do hope they've learned their lesson with the Carrick and avoid doing any sort of thing like this with the merchantman, let's see what sort of cargo it might fit if they do. So assuming 130 meters for the length now, just based on the Carrick's length, and also applying the cargo space reduction to account for pathing and whatnot, we get around 3,000 SCU, which again was a surprise to me. That's still a bit under the listed number, but that's a whole lot of cargo capacity, and I think they could change the layout a bit if they wanted to get to that 3,500 number. So yeah, I was kinda hoping to find out that there would just be no way for them to fit that much cargo into a ship that fits into large hangars, so I could say that it was probably not gonna shrink back down, but from these very rough estimates, it doesn't seem impossible. It has gotten a price increase, but I don't think that necessarily means it's staying at its current size either, since even at the smaller size, I think the flight-ready price would be a bit higher than what it is now. So yeah, I think there is potential that the ship could be downsized a bit from its current 160 meters, but that might be a good thing if it makes it faster, and therefore better at making fast trade runs and protecting its cargo. As for the rest of the capabilities of this ship, we have even less to go off of. One thing I think we can be sure of though is this ship will be keeping its marketplace features. That's one of the core features of this ship and one of the main uses the Banu have for it, so yeah, there's no way that that's gonna get cut out to make space for anything else. I do think there is potential for its supposed combat capability to get toned down a bit, just cause that would make it such a good all-around ship, but thinking about it some more and considering the probable trajectory for its price, and also the fact that backers have been waiting for it for so long, it might still keep most of those features. Now, a lot of the reason for the ship's capabilities often being called into question, beyond the fact that this would make it a really good ship, is the existence of the Kraken Privateer, which has a lot in common with this thing, except for its price tag. The Kraken will also carry a ton of cargo internally and have an internal marketplace. We also do know that it's heavily armed and armored and is pretty massive at 270 meters. So people often talk about how the merchantman would be stepping on the Kraken's toes if it were anywhere near as capable, but I don't think that this is as big of an issue as people make it, because the Kraken has some major features that we know won't be coming to the merchantman, and I think there are plenty to separate the two of them even if their cargo capacity is somewhat similar. First of all, the Kraken is a carrier. Whether you use that space to transport your own ships, or transport ships to sell, or just use it as parking space for customers, this is going to be a massively useful feature, and being able to carry other ships, especially as many as a Kraken, is going to be a very rare and useful feature. Also, the Kraken has other capital class amenities that we probably won't be seeing on the Merchantman. It has a medbay, massive shield with two capital class units, and a whole bunch of well-equipped turrets. So I think looking at other ships with somewhat overlapping roles is possibly a good way to get some context for what CIG might do in terms of balancing the capabilities of these ships. I think a decent comparison is the Polaris and the Idris. They're not quite as similar as the Merchantman and the Privateer, but hear me out. Both the Polaris and the Idris are capital ships, and both are designed to be capable of patrolling areas solo for a long period of time or working together with the fleet. However, they do this on a very different scale. The Polaris carries one fighter, while the Idris can carry three, or possibly more. They both have medical facilities, but I imagine the Idrises will be better equipped, and they both are great combat ships, but again, the Idris is just overall more capable in this area. But yeah, both of these ships are looking to be very solid options, and I think most players who have them are happy with both of them, and they aren't too worried about the capabilities of each ship being similar despite the big price difference. So yeah, I hope the situation with the Merchantman and the Kraken ends up like this. I think that CIG can give the Merchantman its full range of promised capabilities like the combat readiness and high cargo capacity, and not worry too much about the Kraken, since that'll have plenty of features itself to stand out. This is just my opinion though, and I want to hear what you guys think. Do you think the Merchantman has survived this reconcepting mostly fully intact, or do you think there's going to be some stuff missing when we hopefully see it in a few weeks? And what do you think about the comparison with the Kraken Privateer? I've always thought it's weird that the Kraken Privateer even exists, but again, I think they're just different enough ships that it's not going to be that much of an issue. Anyway, that's all I have for this video. I'm really excited to hear more about the Merchantman. It's one of my favorite ships, and whatever shape it might be in a month or so, I think whatever shows up is going to be pretty cool. So if you like this video, please help support the channel by hitting that like or subscribe button, and if you really want to help me out, you can become a member by hitting that join button. I really appreciate it. Thanks for watching!